Welcome back. In this video, let's talk about the fill factor of a solar cell. So fill factor is the figure of merit of a solar cell or a solar panel. It tells us how good or bad a solar panel is. We know that there are two non-idealities in a solar cell or the parasitic resistance in a solar cell. What are those? Shunt resistance RSH and series resistance RSE. These are the two things. Ideally speaking, RSH should be infinity and RSE should be zero. If RSH is infinity and RSE is zero, we'll get the ideal characteristics. That is, you can see that gray color box. It's a square. That square or rectangle is the ideal characteristics of a solar cell. We'll get when RSH is infinity and RSE is zero. That is, shunt resistance is infinity and series resistance is zero. But practically, they are not infinity and zero. And thereby, we'll get a red color curve. That is the IV characteristics of a PV cell. Now, the practical operating point is, now if it is the ideal characteristics, then what is the operating point or the peak power point? It is that blue dot point, which is a peak power, theoretical peak power or the ideal peak power, which is a multiplication of VOC into ISC. VOC into ISC is the actual power drawn by the solar panel when RSH is infinity and RSE is zero, which is called the ideal or theoretical operating point of a solar cell. Now, in practical conditions, we'll get a red curve like that. Right. So, now what is the Pmax, that blue color area, what you can see there, that blue color area rectangle is the maximum power. Practical maximum power, which is a multiplication of Pm is equal to Vm into Im. Now, what is a fill factor? Is a fill factor is the ratio of maximum power to the theoretical power of a solar panel. What is the maximum power? Vm into Im. And what is the theoretical power? VOC into ISC. Therefore, fill factor is nothing but the ratio of Vmax into Imax by VOC into ISC. Right. Fill factor can also be interpreted graphically as the ratio of gray rectangle by the ratio of blue rectangle or cyan rectangle. It is it. So, Vm into Im by VOC into ISC is called the fill factor. It represents the figure of merit or quality of a solar panel. If fill factor is more, then the quality of a solar panel is very high. If fill factor is less, the quality of a solar panel is very less. The fill factor lies in between 0 and 1. So, what are the worst solar panel? These are the practical operating point of a worst solar panel or a bad solar panel. So, if it is, RSH should be as high as possible and RSE should be as low as possible. Ideally, RSH should be infinity and RSE should be zero. But practically, if it is never possible, therefore RSH value should be as high as possible and RSE value should be as low as possible. In the previous parameters of a solar cell, we have discussed the nominal values of a RSH and RSE. RSH value will be in the range of 200 to 300 ohms, whereas RSE value will be in the range of 0.2 to 0.4 ohms. Right. But if RSH is low and RSE is high, if RSH is decreasing and RSE is increasing, then we will get a worst characteristics. That is, this red color line is the bad solar panel ever characteristics. Now you can see the gray area is very very high and the green area is very very less. Therefore, the ratio of green area by red area, the ratio of green area by gray area is nothing but the solar panel character, the fill factor of a solar panel, which will be very very less. It is the bad ever solar cell. The solar cell, there will be a solar cell characteristics which will be as worst as this. Right. Now, effect of shunt series resistance on the PV cell performance. Now let's take that blue line is the normal curve. Normal curve. Now what I told you, the RSC should be as low as possible. Ideally, it should be zero. If the RSC value is increased, I increase the RSC value from zero to some other value, then the curve will be decreased. The curve will come down. The blue curve will become a green curve. That is, if the value of RSC is increased, then the curve will go down. That is, the performance of a solar cell decreases. Whereas, if I decrease the value of a series resistance, then the value of the curve will, the performance of the solar cell will improve, and thereby the IV curve will move upwards. That is, the blue curve will become a red curve. The blue curve is a nominal, normal curve. If I decrease the value of the shunt resistance, then the curve will move upwards. That is, the performance is improved. If I increase the value of a series resistance, the curve will move downward. That is, the performance is decreased. Increasing series resistance in a PV system flattens the knee in the IV curve. Flattens the knee. That is, the curve is becoming flat. And finally, if it becomes worst, it will become a horizontal, a diagonal line like that. So, it flattens the knee of a IV curve, and thereby reducing the maximum power, fill factor and efficiency. If the series resistance increases, then maximum power decreases, fill factor decreases and efficiency will decrease. The next one. Effect of shunt resistance on the performance of a PV cell. Now let's take the PV cell. The ideal value of a PV, the ideal value of this shunt resistance should be infinity. Let's take the blue curve. It which is having some shunt resistance. Now if I increase the shunt resistance, the curve will shift upwards because the ideal value of a shunt resistance will be infinity. So the shunt resistance should be as high as possible. If I increase the shunt resistance, the blue curve will move upwards and become the red curve, which is the performance of a solar cell is best. Now, otherwise, the second case, if I decrease the shunt resistance, what happens? If I decrease the shunt resistance, the blue curve will shift downwards and becomes a green curve, which is nothing but the performance of a solar cell or panel will be decreased now. It's because of what? Decrease in the shunt resistance, because the ideal value of a shunt resistance should be infinity, but practically it should be as high as possible. If I decrease the value, then the performance will degrade. Therefore, decreasing the shunt resistance will decrease the fill factor, efficiency, as well as it will decrease the performance, that is the efficiency of a solar cell. If the shunt resistance decreases, then the fill factor decreases, efficiency decreases, and maximum power also decreases. Right?